part, I would like to just first give a brief about the problem that we generally face. I mean, it's a general trend nowadays that we want to create a single page applications, but the problem is how to do it. There are frameworks, there are lots of frameworks available, but none of them really came up with the exact same solution what we have in the older version with JSPs and ASP pages. So what ARIA came up with, the templating engine, which allow us to give exactly the same conditions, the conditions that we are very used to in JSPs or in the ASP pages. So I will just show you how we can create a ARIA templates application, just single hello world program, and I will just list out the basic component that we require. So to set up ARIA page applications, what we need to do is, first of all, we need to download the ARIA templates package. There is something called as PayEngine, which ARIA template provides. Using PayEngine, we can configure our the templates, what template we want to use, what template we want to load for particular configurations, what are the URLs we want to give, all user-friendly URLs. So I will just run through the code, how we are basically setting up. So in creating ARIA templates application, this is what our single page looks like. We will have a general structure. We will define what are the resources we want to load. The basic thing that we want to do is we have to load the ARIA template package. So that's the first line that you can see there, ARIA templates. We will give the version name, and this is the core of our application. So what we basically want to do is we would like to initialize our pay engines, and the pay engine will then internally take care of loading the templating. The each template in a pay engine represents a section of HTML which we can configure using pay engine configuration files, which is similar to this, where I have defined what template I want to load for a particular page. So let's say in this case my page is home. For home I have said there is a main layout which is nothing, just a container where I will define what are the different template that I can configure. So if you just see main page, I have defined one container, and using the configurations I have defined that in that particular container I want to load a different template, that is main page. And in the main page template, I just given a single line, hello world, which is right now just a HTML. If you want to configure it further for creating more complex HTML, we can use the div tags, articles, sections, all the HTML5 specifications. In addition, it provides us the power of conditional statements. So like we have mustache.js also available with us, which also gives the same template concept. But in mustache, we can't use if conditions for each loops or maybe other clauses that are available. But in this, in ARIA templates, we have all the freedom. We can use all the conditions, we can iterate over a list, we can parse the JSON, we can do JavaScript operations. Everything can be handled directly inside here. So, if you see our basic setup, I will just show you the basic folder structure that we require to run an application. This is the folder structure. I would have the ARIA package structure. I would have a folder with modules where all my templates and other files are available. And inside modules, I will just list down the basic. Oh, I closed it. What happened? It closed. Sorry, it closed. Yeah. So inside module, we have three different sections: config, pages, template. Template is where we generally place our templates, and these are the configurations. So one more advantage of using this concept is the configuration files. Based on the channels, like we generally want to support adaptive and responsive design. So based on the challenge, what we can do is we can have a different set of configuration files available. Here I have set pages. This may be for one channel. I can have a different folder which may contain the configuration for different channel with different sets of templates. So that way we can make our application adaptive. And just to run the application, so this is what we created last time, a single page applications with a single hello world text, and this is what it will show. So that's it from my side.